Where shall we start? There's three of us. It shouldn't take long.
You got a nerve. Inviting me round for a drink and then roping me in to help clean your car.
Well, it takes Bill and I too long. Six arms are better than four.
Well, don't you think you're overdoing it, Tub? A car only needs polishing once a week, not every day.
We live in a smoky atmosphere. Look at it. A thin layer of smog all over it. Hello, who's been writing messages on the bonnet with their finger? Ernie Biggs loves Elsie Spurgeon. I know that Ernie Biggs. He's the same one who runs along my fence with a stick of chalk. Wait till he comes home from school. I'll hide behind the hedge. I'll jump out on him and I'll wrap his catapult round his neck. I will not have spotty-faced kids defacing my limousine. Go on, wash it off. I want the chrome and the paintwork shining so that you can see your face in it.
I've never known anyone so finicky about their car as you are. I haven't cleaned my car for 3 years.
That is only so that any witnesses won't be able to tell what colour it was. It's a disgrace your car is. You have to feel along the door to find where the handle is. I'm not letting mine get in a state like that. I'm proud of my car. It's the cleanest down this street. Dead elegant, that.
Yeah. I've seen you sitting up there all day at your bedroom window with a feather duster in your hand. And as soon as you see a speck of dust land, you're down. Buckets of water, polish, chamois leathers, hoses, vacuum cleaners, then back upstairs again, waiting for the next bit to land. It's an obsession.
It is not. If I keep it in good nick, I stand to make more money on it if I ever decided to sell it. It's very difficult keeping a car clean down railway cuttings. All those trains going by. And they do it deliberately. I've watched them.
Watched who?
Those drivers. They see me cleaning the car and they deliberately slow down, wait till the wind's in the right direction, then whoosh, a funnel full of dirty black smoke comes hurtling over. And more than once I've had occasion to complain to British Railways about them heaving lumps of coal at it. I think they must be running a sweep down at the shunting yards. Let's see how many times we can hit Hancock's car. It's no joke.
It's kept you in fires since you bought it.
That is not the point. A great lump of Welsh anthracite bouncing off it doesn't do the bonnet any good. Now, come on, the sooner we start this... I'll kill that next door's cat.
Now what's wrong?
Look what he's done. Look what he's done. Horrible great paw marks over the bonnet. Up the window, cross the roof and down the boot. And get my boot if I catch him again. Great ugly thing he is.
Well, come on, if we've got to do it, let's get it over with.
Right, Bill, you get under the car and polish it. Sid, you can do... You take the chamois... You've gone home.
Just a minute. Just a minute. Did you say under the car?
Yes, I did. I want the springs and all the stuff underneath polished right up. I want it shining. Go on, crawl under there, you ratbag.
But, Tub, what's the point? Nobody sees under the car.
They do at the garage when it goes up on the ramp. I don't want them to look underneath my car and say, ooh, isn't it dirty? I'm not all outward show, you know. I'm not like those women who just dust round the ornaments. Underneath, mate. Then you can lift the bonnet up and polish the engine.
Shall I take the tyres off and wash the inner tubes?
Yes, you can do that afterwards. Then you can let the air out and put some fresh in. I want it looking just like it did when it came out of the showroom. Right, to work. There. Let's have a look. Oh, that's a bit better, isn't it?
It ought to be. Blimey, 3.5 hours of continual rubbing. I swear my right arm's 3 inches shorter than the other.
If a job is worth doing, it is worth doing well. Look at it gleaming there.
Yeah. Well, I still don't like the colour scheme, and I never have.
Don't like the colour scheme? Orange and heliotrope? Very voguey, that is.
I think it's the tartan hood that spoils it.
Because you've got no taste, have you? You've got to have something bright for the hood to balance up with the pink wall tyres.
Yeah, all you want is a couple of plants in there, and it'll look like a travelling coffee bar. Is it clean enough for you?
It'll do for now. We'll have another 3 hours on it tomorrow. Bill, have you finished the underneath? Where is he?
His legs are poking out the other side.
I bet he's asleep. I've a good mind to jump on his ankles. Love to see him spring up and hit his head on the big end. Or shall I start the engine up? His ear holes right by the end of the exhaust pipe.
No.
Hang on. Pull your legs in, there's a bus coming.
What bus? Where? Ooh, ah,
oh! Dear, I did enjoy that. I bet his knees felt that. He didn't half fetch them a whack on that running board. My running board. If you've damaged that running board, you will have the benefit of my starting handle across your nose.
I haven't hurt your running board.
Ooh-wee, dinner ready.
You better go in now, otherwise she'll eat it all. Put a barrage balloon over the car in case it rains, will you?
Well, you must all be very hungry after all that work you've done. I've made a nice big dish full of cauliflower cheese.
Oh. I don't like cauliflower cheese.
Neither do I.
Don't you really?
You know we don't like cauliflower cheese. You've always known it.
Oh, well, never mind. I just have to eat it all myself.
You planned that. You made it on purpose. You're always doing that. You've made a list of everything we don't like, then you deliberately go and make dirty great binfuls of it. Oh, you gannet.
You can have bread and dripping.
Thank you very much indeed. The perfect Sunday dinner, roast bread and dripping. Most appetizing, the height of luxury. Draw the curtains. I don't want the neighbours looking in, seeing a man of my caliber eating bread and dripping.
Turn it up, Gridley. You must have something else in there.
No, there's no more.
She's hidden it all. She buries it somewhere. She's like something out of Armand and Michaela Dennis. She drags it all off to her lair and stands guard over it.
The car looks nice.
Don't change the subject. Bread and dripping.
I'm hungry after all that work. I think I'll have some cauliflower cheese.
Yeah, I might as well too.
But you don't like it. You said you didn't like it. You told me you didn't.
That's frightened her. She didn't expect that. I'll have some too. Yeah, it's worth making yourself ill just to see her face. Drops 2 inches every spoonful we take. Where's me blindfold? I can't look at it and eat it. Miss Pugh, the front door.
Oh, yes, right you are.
There's no need to take your cauliflower cheese with you. We're not going to pinch it.
All right, but I know exactly how much is there.
Oh, go and open the door.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Oh, good afternoon, Constable. Mr. Hancock, it's a policeman.
Quick. Quick, slap Sid on the back. He swallowed his cauliflower. It's all right, Sid, boy. He's not after you.
Blimey. I know he don't want me. I haven't done anything for weeks. Just whenever I hear the word, copper, turns my stomach right over. I'll be all right in a minute.
Won't you come in, Constable? Anything I can do for you? Have some cauliflower cheese.
No, thank you, sir. I'm on duty.
Oh, well, put some in your helmet for after.
Very, very kind of you, sir, but I'd rather not.
You're very wise. What can I do for you?
That's your car parked outside.
Yes, that's right. Magnificent vehicle, isn't she? Everybody round here admires her. Wonderful condition she's in.
Move it.
Pardon?
Move it.
Move it? Move it? Have you taken leave of your senses?
The aforementioned vehicle is causing an obstruction. Move it.
Oh, come now, my good man. I live here. It's parked outside my own house.
Your property only extends as far as those horrible chickens cut out in your hedge.
Horrible chickens? They are not chickens, Mush. They are birds of paradise. It's the milkman. His horse has been at him. Oh, yes. Yes, he has the cart up on the pavement getting at those. I shall be glad when he gets electrified and has a cart with handle to pull round.
Be that as it may, your property only extends up to the hedge. The pavement and the roadway thereafter are public thoroughfares for use without let or hindrance to the public at large. Move it.
I will not move it. There is no law to say a man may not park his car outside his own front door.
Well, normally we don't mind. We don't bother about short periods. But that car hasn't been moved for 10 years.
10 years? Do you mean to tell me you've had a cleaning that car every day and you never use it?
Well, I get in the driving seat sometimes and I turn the wheel and a bit of rum 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 and pretend and that. But if you mean actually moving, no.
Why not?
Because I can't pass the test. I've been up 73 times and they keep failing me. I just can't get the hang of it. My feet are too big, that's the trouble. They overlap. I put my foot on the brake, half of it goes on the accelerator as well, and we're off again.
Your feet are no concern of mine. That car must be moved.
But it's doing no harm. It's only standing there.
It is doing harm. This road has been resurfaced 8 times since the war, all except the bit your car is standing on. Yeah, I measured it just now. It's 8 inches lower than the rest of the road. We want to fill it in, so move it.
I will not move it.
Those are your last words?
They are, sir.
Very well. And the powers now invested in us by the new Traffic Act, I shall make arrangements for the car to be towed away.
You will do no such thing. Putting chains round my front bumper and lifting it up onto its hind legs? They'd scratch it. I've lavished hours of loving care on that car, and I'm not having it desecrated by the likes of you.
It's got to be moved.
It cannot be moved. I have got nowhere to put it.
Put it in a garage.
I have not got a garage.
Then put it in your front garden. Knock down them chickens and push it through there.
That's the trouble with the country today. I mean, there's no respect for the aristocracy at all. I am not moving that car. There it is, and there it stays. Until such time as I pass my test and can afford a gallon of petrol. I know my rights. This is not a main road. No buses run down here. There are no zebra crossings. It's well away from all corners, and there are two of my own hurricane lamps lighting it up. It is also within 25 yards of a street lamp, the design of which, incidentally, I do not approve of. Taking things all round, therefore, I am perfectly within my rights, parking my car there, and I shall resist any efforts to move it.
But we've got to mend the road.
Then you'll just have to mend round it again and tell the tar sprayer to watch what he's doing. I had to chisel open the door last time.
Yes, but don't you
see... There is no more to be said. Might is not right. Temper it with justice. Rex versus Crippin, third day. Crippin speaking, 79 for 3. So if you will kindly take your helmet off the teapot, I shall bid you good day.
Very well. I shall have to make a report. And no doubt you will be hearing from the magistrate's court within the next few days.
Good. And I shall answer any charge in person. I am willing to defend my civil liberties, whatever you try to do to me. I'm not frightened. Use your rubber hoses and your lights in the face. And all smoking while I haven't got one. See if I care. And it's no use trying to come round and tow it away because I'm taking the wheels off. Huh. That showed him. They admit they're matching me. Now, let's finish my dinner. I bet he thought, where's my cauliflower cheese gone? Who has had my cauliflower? It's her. She's woofed it. She's like greased lightning. I only took my eyes off it for 30 seconds. I bet it never touched the sides on its way down. Stone me. No wonder the dustmen don't bother to call here. All they get is ashes. Oh, spread me some bread and dripping.
Fined 25 shillings, license endorsed. Next case, Constable, please.
John Dillinger, driving across ploughed field, looking for proposed London-Birmingham roadway.
Drunk?
Yes.
£5, disqualified 6 months. Next.
Jack Bradley, over 90 miles an hour up the wrong side of a dual carriageway.
Over 90 miles an hour.
Must have been. It didn't even make a white blob on our radar screen.
£4, license endorsed. Next.
Anthony Hancock, parking 10 years.
Not guilty, Your Honor. I wish to defend myself.
Oh, dear, why do they bother? Must you?
I must. In the fair name of British justice and liberty, I demand my rights as a citizen.
Oh, dear, it is one of those. Very well, continue.
Milad! My car has been parked outside 23 railway cuttings, my own abode, mark you, in a de-restricted street without any complaints from the neighbours, passing pedestrians or cars. It does no harm. It merely enhances the neighbourhood with its beauty. In my profession, it is essential to have a motor vehicle at my disposal all hours of the day in case I have to dash off to rehearsals.
But you haven't used it for 10 years.
So you can see I am in no position to pay the fine. But I may get some work any day now. You have to be there quick in case somebody else gets it. Therefore, I submit that there is no case to answer. I am perfectly within my rights to leave my car where it is. There is no law to prevent from doing so. There is nothing anyone can do to stop me. And therefore, I demand. Yea, demand. That I be found not guilty, discharged, and walk from this court a free man.
Fine, 40 shillings next.
Let me lack.
Fine, 45 shillings next.
I object, Your Honor.
50 shillings next.
This is a travesty of justice.
55 shillings. Will you allow me to get on with the next case, or will you go on for the £3? Oh. And one other thing.
Yes?
Move it. Next.
Judge Percy Francis.
That's me.
Yes, sir. Your car is parked outside in a restricted area.
Oh, I see. Well, now, fine, 50, 10 shillings. And licensing. I mean, don't do it again. A court adjourned. That's ridiculous.
I am not moving it.
You got to, son. The court ruled against you.
They have no right to make me move my car. I've got nowhere to put it.
Well, they reckon you could leave it out in the front garden.
I am not ruining my glads and daffs for anybody. It's taken me 3 years to get those bulbs right. You wait till they come up. I've got me coat of arms in one bed. And there's the number of the house in another. And then there's me face in the centre.
Very nice. I thought you were going to have a clock.
Well, it's combined. Me face is the dial and the hands are stuck on me nose. So when they're pointed to each ear, it's 10 to 2.
Oh, I got it. And at 3:15, you're going to look like Jimmy Edwards.
That's it. So you see, I can't have my car in the front garden. It'll completely spoil it. And besides, to get it in, I'll have to tear down my chickens. Me birds of paradise, and I'm not doing that either.
Anyone for stuffed cabbage?
No.
No.
Good, I'll make some. Where's Bill?
He's outside cleaning the car. The 11:23 to Waterloo went by just now. 15 direct hits and 2 clouds of smoke, and there it is.
Tub, come quickly.
What's wrong?
The police have arrived with a breakdown wagon. They're going to tow the car away. They're putting the chains round it now.
You fool, why didn't you stop them?
Well, I tried to. They put the hook under me collar and swung me over the fence.
If you landed on my flower beds...
I didn't do much damage, Tub. I missed the chickens, but I think I landed on your snowdrops.
You nincompoop. Do you realize what this means? When my face grows, I won't have any teeth. I shall deal with you later. I'm going to have some words with these blue-coated vandals. Take those chains off my car. I'll have the law on you.
We are the law.
Bill, lie down the road in front of the lorry.
Hey, Tub, I...
Lie down in front of the lorry.
But they might run me over.
This is a chance I'm going to have to take. Lie down.
Now, come along, sir. Don't be foolish. Get up out of the road.
You stay there, Bill. They can't trample roughshod over private citizens.
Are you going to get up, sir?
No, you're not going to touch my friend's car, so there.
Right, Fred. Lower the hook. Hook it under his belt. All away! That's it. Swing him clear.
Put me down.
Yes, you put my friend down.
That's it, Fred. Swing him over the edge.
Help, Tom. Help.
I demand you release him.
Righto, Fred. Let him go.
Not over me, flower bed. Stone me. That's me nose and one of me ears gone for a bit. You've disfigured my clock, you vandals. I'll sue you for damages.
I think I've broken some bones, Tub.
Oh, shut up. I shall write to the vicar about this.
Right, Fred. Get the hook round the bumper again. That's it. Right, all away.
Be careful. It won't take the strain.
Well, that's the bumper moved anyway. Throw it in the back of the lorry. Fred, drive round and hitch up the other bumper. We'll get it from behind.
Leave it alone. There'll be questions asked in the house about this. Hello, the 1141 of Victoria. Duck everybody behind the fence.
Well, you won the first round, Hancock. Your car's still there.
Of course it's still there. They've come up against a fighter in me.
Well, you had a bit of help, boy. You were dead lucky that train went past just then. That copper didn't know what time it was when a lump of coal hit him on the back of the head.
He still doesn't. He hasn't come round yet. He's in the cottage hospital.
Good shots, those train drivers, aren't they? They missed the other one, so I picked up a brick and let him have it. He said, where's Zim? Where's Bill?
Oh, he's still lying out in the flower bed, moaning and groaning.
Don't you think we ought to go out and bring him in?
No, if he wants to come in, let him crawl in. Great oaf falling on me set piece. Skylarking about on cranes, it's his own fault.
They'll be back, you know. They won't let you get away with it. You can't fight the law. They'll put you in jail for this.
You always put the mockers on everything, don't you? Why don't you get back in the kitchen and mind your own business? What is for dinner?
You don't like stuffed marrow, do you?
No, I do not.
Well, that's what we're having, then.
Stuffed marrow, stuffed cabbage and cauliflower cheese. Can't you forget you used to work in a British restaurant? She's half cooked some rubbish. All her wartime recipes here. Potato peat stuck up in the kitchen there. It's not good enough for a gourmet like me, a man of my taste. The war's over, dear. There's other food about now. I've got a very delicate palate. Nothing but the finest. Subtle, exotic, fleeting savouries. That's what I want. Why can't we have egg and chips and a bottle of chop salt? We never get anything imaginative round here.
Tub! Tub!
Oh, it's you. He can't be too badly hurt. He opened the door by himself. What do you want?
They're back, Tub. They've got the road menders ready to start as soon as the car's moved.
Well, they won't move it this time. It's bolted to the road and chained to the lamppost.
They're not trying to move it this time. They've got a great steamroller up against it. They reckon it'll just about fill in the hole. Then all they've got to do is spray some tar over it.
They can't do that. Bill, go and lay in front of the steamroller.
No, I can't do that, Tub. I can't move.
Sid, help me carry him out there. Open the door. Right, up, up to you.
Careful, I got his feet.
Put me down. Stop it. I don't want to be flattened. I don't want to be part of the road.
Not so much of the old lip there. Right, keep that steamroller away from my limousine.
Now, we don't want any more trouble, sir. I'm willing to forget the last little fracas, but we're not having any more.
It wasn't my fault. I told you to duck. How's your head?
Nasty. Quite nasty. All these bandages. I can't get my helmet on.
Never mind. Paint them all black and stick a badge on them. Nobody will notice. Right, Sid, put him down in front of the steamroller.
Now, come along. Now, get up. Laying in front of steamrollers is forbidden in this country.
I can't move. My ankle's gone.
Look, sir, we can't go on like this, can we?
No, we can't.
This bit of road under your car must be brought up to the same level as the rest of the road. It's dangerous otherwise.
I appreciate your point, officer, but I am not moving my car. I refuse to be coerced.
Well, then, let's talk it over. Let's have what we might call a summit conference between the heads of state.
Well, I'm always open to reason. What are your proposals to end the Cold War?
Well, how about this? We move your car 20 yards up the road until this bit's been levelled up and resurfaced, and you can move it back, and we say no more about it.
That seems very reasonable. You guarantee that I won't have any more trouble.
Well, not for another 10 years till we have to fill the road in again.
Very well. I agree. Well,
thank you very much, sir.
I mean, you'll appreciate. I mean, there was nothing personal against your good self. Throughout the whole affair, you conducted yourself with the utmost dignity and in a fashion most befitting a member of the Cheam Constabulary.
Thank you, sir. I must say, I've admired your tenacity in standing up for your rights.
Thank you.
Are we friends again?
Certainly. Little fingers?
Oh.
Well, old man, help me push the car along and we can start immediately.
But what about him in the road?
I'll push him in the gutter. He'll probably fall asleep.
Well, congratulations, Hancock. You did it. The car's back in its rightful position. I never thought you'd do it.
It just shows you that when you believe in something, you've got to fight for it.
Hello. The 10:42 to Waterloo's going by.
There they go. They've started heaving coal at it again.
Hey, blimey, they're hitting it every time. Look.
They'll smash it up. Great chunks going through the windows. Look, my windscreen's gone. Look, 4 bits gone through the hood.
Their aim's improving, isn't it? They haven't missed once. They must have a rangefinder on board. Here, Hancock, that car won't be able to take much more punishment like that. I can't understand it. They've never been so accurate before.
Well, of course, I've just realised. You know what's happened? Their aim hasn't improved at all. Now the road's been built up, the car's up much higher. They can see it better. They've got more to aim at. I knew I should have held out and not let them do that road.
Well, what are you going to do about it, then? Move the car?
No, I am not. There is only one way to deal with this. We've got to stop those trains going by. Bill?
Yeah?
Come here.
What do you want?
Go and lay on the railway line.
No, I won't.
Grab him. Miss Pugh, some rope. We'll tie him across the line.
No, Tub, please, don't do it.
Take his legs. We've got to stop the 12:23.
Why am I always the...
Look, it won't hurt, Bill. You just lay in front of the train. We'll see who gives in first.
Yeah, but I always get this sort
of... You can trust me, Bill. We're not going to take this line down. Well, I mean, you are, but...
Oh, no, not this time. Once
it's the only way. Force must match force.
How many times have I asked you, Tub? Hey.